With our lives becoming increasingly connected to the internet, we're likely to see the growth of things like cyber insurance. How do we even start, though, to put a price on our data? And do governments themselves have to start budgeting to protect their populations from cyber extortion? The WannaCry attack targeted Microsoft's Windows operating system using ransomware. It blocked access to computer systems and demanded that victims pay money via the cryptocurrency Bitcoin. The world's biggest software maker was quick to point the finger of blame at the US government. But some experts say that Microsoft is accountable too for the way in which it charges for new versions of its software. Our technology editor Tariq Bazley reports on the global nature of the latest threat.
Many countries were on alert as the working week began, fearing the spread of the computer virus would speed up as millions powered on their Windows computers. In China, a leading security software company reported nearly 30,000 institutions, including government agencies and universities, had been hurt. Part of the virus, that which allows it to spread from computer to computer, is believed to have been developed by the US National Security Agency, the NSA. It's thought the code was then later stolen by hackers and leaked sometime later. Last month, Microsoft, the maker of Windows, gave users a security update to prevent computers from becoming infected. Now the company's president has hit out at the NSA and says the attack should be a wake-up call for governments. In an online post, Brad Smith said,
"Repeatedly, exploits in the hands of governments have leaked into the public domain and caused widespread damage. An equivalent scenario with conventional weapons would be the US military having some of its Tomahawk missiles stolen. And this most recent attack represents a completely unintended but disconcerting link between the two most serious forms of cybersecurity threats in the world today: nation-state action and organized criminal action."
Other industry analysts say although the NSA may have created part of the virus's code, other similar code is available and being constantly developed by hackers.
The codes like this can be developed by anyone. Any unethical or cyber criminal could develop that code. And so it's more of a responsibility on the information security community, but people, customers, companies, governments, to work harder on securing technologies that we're depending more and more upon.
The spread of the virus appears to have slowed when a British researcher found a so-called kill switch. Security updates also stopped the virus infecting millions more computers. But many security analysts warn there are always new threats. And while this may have been the largest attack of its kind yet, it's unlikely to be the last.
Joining